There are probably over 50 reports in Google Analytics. Which one should you be using? In this video, I'm going to show you my favorite report in Google Analytics and why I chose this one over the others. Hey there, and welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and today we want to talk about my favorite Google Analytics report of all times. Now, like Google Analytics implementations, it's actually pretty custom to what your functionality is in a business and what report you should be looking at. In the end, Google Analytics is really just a question answering machine where you ask the question and you look in the right report and then try to find the answer through the tools they have available and the visualizations that they have available. But I wanted to show you what my favorite report in Google Analytics is. And maybe you have guessed it already, or maybe you are using that report as well. And I'd love to hear from you later on down below in the comments if that is the same report that you were thinking about, or if you have another special report that you look on often. So without further ado, let's dive into my favorite report. All right, so welcome to my favorite report. This is the Source Medium report. You can find it under the acquisition and the Source Medium. Now, why is this my favorite report? It's actually the report that I would choose to look at if there would be no other reports in Google Analytics. This is the most valuable part of it all, at least for a first analysis. And it's really about being an online marketer and caring about where my users come from. And this is the question that this report answers quite well, and even goes a step further, telling me how it's performing and in some instances how I can improve it. Now, first up, what is Source Medium? Source Medium is a classification of Google Analytics determining where your users came from when they entered your website. As opposed to the other reporting that we have about channels, Source Medium is really the raw data point that comes in that you can influence through UTM parameters. If you don't know what UTM parameters are, then I'd urge you to check out the video I'm gonna link up in the description below, or you see it up here in the card as well. So every time a user enters your website, starts a new session, he gets sorted into one of these rows here that tell us where the user came from. We can quickly analyze the most important traffic sources for us. So in this case, the organic search results of Google, any other important referrals, how well paid advertising is doing, Google CPC, for example, and also the traffic that Google couldn't classify. I always call this dead traffic. It doesn't really hold any insights because we don't know where this traffic actually came from. So my inclination is always to try to decrease that amount and actually send in traffic with UTM parameters attached. Now in these metric fields, we get a great overview of what happens to the traffic once it enters our website. We have this model of ABC analysis, that's acquisition, behavior, and conversions. You might be familiar with these terms from the big reportings up here, acquisition, behavior, conversions. These really are digging deeper into these aspects of our analysis. And these really answer the question, where does our traffic come from? What do they do on our website? And do they reach our goal of our website? Now down here, everything is broken down by these different source mediums, and we can see line by line how these stack up against each other. This is quite great because we can quickly compare different sources against each other. For instance, Google is bringing us most of the traffic, but the e-commerce conversion is much lower as opposed to this referral source, much lower traffic, but the conversion is much higher. Maybe we should be working on increasing this traffic source here as it has a much higher chance to convert. If you don't see any data in your e-commerce reports, it might be that you have goals installed. But if you see no data at all, then it means you don't have goals installed, and this is something that you definitely should do. We have some videos on this channel as well on how to set up goals in Google Analytics. Back to the e-commerce reports. Let's have another look at the different metrics that we see right here. So for example, in the Google CPC column, we can analyze how effective our traffic is that comes from our paid advertising on google.com. We get a decent amount of traffic, and that traffic bounces to 57%. What does that mean? Well, 57% of the users that actually enter the website through the source Google CPC only have one page view in that session, which gives us an idea how relevant the actual landing page is in connection to the actual ad. So what does the user expect once he clicks on an ad? To come to a website where he can find a product, for example. If he doesn't find that, he will bounce. So overall, you will try to decrease this bounce rate and help the user at least to go to the next page and interact with your page further. But this only happens if your ad is really relevant to the user and he finds on the next page when he clicks through that there's a relevant product that he wants to buy. Well, once the user is on the page, he clicks through and on average looks at 3.61 pages in that session and stays for an amount of 1 minute 52 seconds. Again, these numbers don't mean anything by their own. You would need to compare them against your other traffic sources and see where you might need to improve a traffic source if that's in the realm of your marketing efforts. And then we see how many people of those people who entered the website and clicked through actually converted and how much revenue they have generated. Now, the revenue is also a great indicator. If you are responsible for these AdWords ads, you probably know how much you have spent on the account in a given period and therefore can do a quick ROI analysis and see if this is still a profitable campaign for you. So really quick insights through this report, just through asking these questions: where does my user come from? What does he do on the website? And did he convert and reach my goal? Now, obviously, we can go deeper into some of these traffic sources like Google CPC, but that's really what these other reports are all about. You have your AdWords reports, your Search Console reports, if you want to dig deeper into the organic aspect of your traffic, and referral reports, which help you to analyze these different source mediums under the aspect that is important when comparing referrals to each other or social sources to each other. And once you have a broad overview of what data you want to dig into, you will have more questions. And this is what Google Analytics is all about, to actually start investigating, start analyzing, using the tools like the custom segment builder up here or different visualization methods to understand your user behavior better, answering those questions that you have asked and getting to a conclusion, a recommendation, or an actual action that you take in your marketing accounts, for example, to influence these different metrics. But the starting point for most of my analysis is really this source medium report that lets me start forming the first hypothesis, the first questions that I want to investigate further. And that's why I think that this is the most valuable report within Google Analytics.
All right, so there you have it. This is my favorite report in Google Analytics. I might be biased because I'm first and foremost still a marketer and I want to control where my traffic is coming from and how it's performing so I can optimize and bring more qualified traffic to the website that I'm using. Now, this said, I actually dig deeper into different other reports because this is first my starting point. It's my favorite report because I get questions from it. I see something in the report that is interesting and then I try to find out, or I get a new question and I try to find out in different other reports why that is so. And maybe I will go deeper into the AdWords or the SEO section of Google Analytics to find out more about how I can optimize this given channel. Now, that said, if you are a PPC guy or SEO guy, or you are an e-commerce manager, or you are a developer of the website, you might be looking at totally different reports, and this is totally fine as well. This is just my personal preference, and I'd love to hear from you what you find so interesting in the reports that you look at most often. Please leave a comment down below and let others know about your experience with your favorite report. Now, if you haven't yet, then consider subscribing right over there because we'll bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.